Welcome to DSIM Architecture. My name is Andrea, and I'm here with Ram from United Airlines. Hi, Ram. Welcome to the show.
Hi, Andrea. Excited to be here.
So what does United Airlines do?
United, as everyone knows, is a global airline company with hundreds of destinations around the world.
Wonderful. So today we're here to talk about the centralized backup solution that you built on AWS. Mm-hmm. In a nutshell, what is it?
So I am part of the cloud engineering team, which where we govern all the AWS accounts at mm-hmm. United. And this solution we came up because we wanted to protect United cloud infrastructure from a ransomware event.
Okay, so it sits on AWS, mm-hmm. and I want to dive straight into the architecture. Mm-hmm. So assume, you know, I'm an application owner, mm-hmm. I need to back up my applications. Okay. Can you walk us through the flow? Where does it start?
Okay, sure. Thanks, Andrea. So every application has an IAM role, right? Okay. So when that IAM role is created, this IAM role triggers a CloudTrail event.
Okay.
So the CloudTrail event is forwarded to the event bridge in the master account. This part is a child account, like, you know, one of the child accounts we have, mm-hmm. More than 150 accounts. This is a central account where we manage all this central backup solution. So this event bridge triggers a step function, and the step function takes the CloudTrail as the payload. And so the step function is a series of Lambda functions.
Okay.
In the Lambda function, that creates a backup.
I see.
It creates a backup. So part of that one is, like, it creates a backup vault. It creates a backup policy. And the backup policy tells the backup how often the backup needs to be taken and the where the backup needs to be copied.
I see. So it's a series of events occurring, you know, leading to creation of the backup mm-hmm. Vault mm-hmm. as well as the replication plan.
Exactly.
Right? And how many, tell us, you know, how many backups are you performing?
So we backup we backup a lot. Like, for example, okay. each application has one backup vault. But in general, we have two primary regions. So the backup, when a backup is taken, it copies it to both the regions, as well as it copies it to a network isolated region to protect it from a ransomware event.
Okay, to protect it from compromise.
From being compromised. Yes.
And you mentioned, you know, the number of child accounts that you carry. Uh-huh. I think you heard 150, is that correct?
Child accounts right now, we have almost upward of 175 accounts.
175, okay.
Yes. Yeah.
And then how many applications are you protecting and how much backups are you performing?
So we have almost upward of 300 applications.
Okay.
And that number is fast increasing as the AWS presence increases within United. And we almost backup 2 petabytes of data.
Wow. That's extreme scale.
Yes.
Now, you know, as I perform my backups mm-hmm. and as an application owner, it's been compromised mm-hmm. and I want to restore.
Mm-hmm.
Can you walk us through that?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
So if an application, for whatever reason, it doesn't need to be a compromised scenario, or they may wanted to restore a backup, you know, let's say a DynamoDB or a RDS, EBS volumes or a Neptune DB, anything mm-hmm. that is supported by. So what they do is they go to our ServiceNow and open a help hub request.
Mm.
We're providing all the information what needs to be restored. The ServiceNow triggers a CloudFormation template,
okay.
providing all the information as an input. This CloudFormation creates an IAM role.
I see.
This IAM role is a just-in-time access. So for example, like, you know, if they wanted to have, you know, how long they wanted to have this IAM role to be available. So once they complete their function, that policy is again removed and nobody will have access to the backup vault. That IAM role gives access to this particular backup vault that particular application.
Okay, and you get a time-based token maybe to retrieve from that backup,
correct?
Exactly. Okay, perfect. Yeah. And then let's talk about visibility mm-hmm. into this,
mm-hmm.
right? I think you have operations team. I do see QuickSight.
Yes.
How have you leveraged QuickSight?
Yeah, so the dashboarding part, we leverage QuickSight heavily.
Okay.
So the QuickSight is available in our central account, as you can see.
I see.
Right? Like, so mm-hmm. all the information whenever a backup is happens that is sent to the event bridge that performs a series of functions. Eventually, all the information is stored in Athena tables. QuickSight leverages the Athena tables to provide that functionality, and our operational teams gets visibility into all the backups that are happening.
I see.
For example, let's say what failures are happening, or how often the backups are happening, just a general count. So all that information is available for us
in the QuickSight.
Custom dashboards
to have visibility through the event bridge.
Correct? Exactly.
Okay,
yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Thank you, Ram, for walking us through this architecture where you have automated the backup and restore of 2 petabytes of data.
Thanks a lot for the opportunity, Andrea.
And thank you for watching This Is My Architecture.